the chief operating officer by the CEO of the bank, and we had to answer three specific questions. The first question was, what is the situation on the Bulgarian market as regards the alternative delivery channels? What type of alternative delivery or distribution channels the banks in Bulgaria are using, the major banks? The second question was, okay, what stays as an operational model behind the development of these distribution channels? How are they working? And the third question that we needed to answer in our research was, what is the optimal model that the bank should adopt in order to be successful when developing these channels? So, we started working with the chief operating officer on this task. We researched a lot of literature, and we researched also a lot of websites of other banks abroad in order to answer this question, as well as to answer the first question, what is the situation of the Bulgarian market. So, first of all, we need to define distribution channels, alternative distribution channels. Alternative distribution channels in banking are all the sales channels different from the traditional bank branch. So these are e-banking, m-banking, ATMs, phone banking. All they are considered alternative distribution channels to the traditional channel, which is considered the branch. Now, what is the situation currently on the Bulgarian market? What are the big banks in Bulgaria offering currently? If we take a look at the picture, we see that most of the big banks in Bulgaria, these are the biggest six banks in Bulgaria, in terms of asset classes, by end of 2013, and we see that most of the banks have developed a full range of alternative distribution channels except for phone banking. We see that some of the big banks, like UniCredit, Global Bank and Raiffeisen, have kept developing phone banking because they consider that this is no longer so much important as a channel, given the fact that most people are using mobile phones and tablets. But we see that, in general, the big banks in Bulgaria are moving together with the latest trends in world banking. Okay, I'm going to skip some of the presentation because I think it's too detailed. Whoever is interested can find a lot of details in my paper. But what was interesting for us was to see, answering the second question, was to see how was the organization dealing with the distribution, alternative distribution channels. I mean, how all these banks were running the alternative channels. And we saw that each of the banks in Bulgaria, the six biggest banks in Bulgaria, have its own way. There was no common approach followed on the market towards the managing of all these distribution channels. So, in some cases, as you can see, in some cases, some of the banks have preferred to have fragmented management of these channels, which means that the management was scattered between operations, the sales unit, and IT. Other banks had more functions concentrated in the sales unit, which is branch network. Other banks have chosen to try to integrate to some extent the channels. So the conclusion was that there was no common approach followed on the market. However, the most important and most difficult question in our research needed to be answered directly. And we needed to find a specific answer to what is the optimal model. Okay, each bank selects its own pathway, but what was the best? And having researched the different options that exist also in literature on the question and that exist in World Bank practice, which means some banks tend to concentrate alternative distribution channels function in the sales unit, other banks tend to do that in the operational unit, so the operational unit is running these channels, other banks consider integrated approach, So having considered these three opportunities and these three possibilities, we reach the conclusion that actually, the best model and the optimal model of the integrated management model, which means that there is an integrated unit in the bank, which is managing all alternative distribution channels for sales, which means that alternative distribution channels are not managed by branch network division for the sales part, by IT division for the IT related part, and by operations division for the operational part of the work, but there is a unit which is created for the purpose in the organization and which is given the task to develop a strategy for the alternative distribution channels, to follow it up, to deal with all the operational and IT related matters, and in such a way to have the complete responsibility for the development of all these channels. Because World Bank practice shows that when responsibilities are scattered among various divisions, then it's very difficult to manage. It's very difficult to manage the process, and a lot of lack of efficiency occurs as a result. So, coming back to the situation of the Bulgarian market, we can say that to date, no bank from the big players on the market has reached this type of approach. No bank has managed to fully integrate the management of the alternative distribution channels, which means that we have a long way still to go, but if we acknowledge what is the right direction and we are making steps towards it, we can reach it. So, this was in brief, in a nutshell, what we found out as a result of our exercise. Finally, because this is the goal also in our university, always to try to present and to try to research topics which can be used in practice in the business. Finally, the outcome of this research was presented to the executive board of the bank, and the findings were accepted, and there was a general acceptance of the fact that we need to move in that direction. So this was satisfactory for us as academics that the result of our work found actually was accepted, and that it will be realized in practice. And of course, if you need more details, you can find it in the paper, you can see it in the presentation, and I'm here at your disposal now if you have any questions to try to answer them.